Hello and welcome to the Django DRF project, eCommerce. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials which you can watch for free. The link to the YouTube course playlist is in the video description. This course is also available on Udemy, where you can watch the course ad-free, download the tutorial source code, and access all updated tutorials and playlist. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. Python Black is a formatting tool which is going to automatically format, structure visually our code on the page consistently throughout our application. Now, there are a few different ways of installing Black within our application. Now, recently, as of recording this tutorial, Black became an official extension. So if I type in Black here into the extensions, there should be a Microsoft, there we go, Black formatter by Microsoft. So you could simply just go ahead and install Black from there. Now, I prefer to have a more dynamic environment in that I like to have a little bit more control over the environment. So I prefer to install Black directly from the Python package index and configure it separately. So that's the steps, or that's the stages, or that's the process that we're going to take in this tutorial. So you can see here that I've completely closed my project. So we're going to need to open the project folder, which is in my documents, and then it's in GitHub. And inside of here, it's the Django DRF commerce. So I need to open that up. And there should be a virtual environment. There is. Now let's remember. Oh, what happened there? So let's open up our terminal. So I've used the shortcut there. You can drag up or go to view and the terminal. Don't forget. So from here, first of all, we need to create or activate the virtual environment. So let's do that first. And then we need to cd into DRF eCommerce folder. So if you're on Windows, you don't type in source, it's just venv scripts activate, don't forget. If you're not too sure, then do go back to the guide at the start of the course and or make some notes. It's definitely something that you'll be doing a lot of and forgetting, so definitely worth making some notes there. So let's go into that folder. So we're now in the folder where the requirements file resides. Now I think the requirements have already been installed, so we don't need to do anything there. So let's just check this. So we're going to install Black. Right, so let's pip install. It's just Black. So this is going to download. It's going to download from the Python package index. So we now have Black installed. So let's go ahead now and pip freeze before we forget. Save that to the requirements file. So that should now appear here. Yep. So we're using Black 22.12.0. Again, regarding version numbers, there isn't going to be too much difference here with Black. So whether you're using a later version or an earlier version, it's not going to make much of a difference here. As I keep mentioning though, and I won't mention it again, if you do find there are any problems with any of the extensions, particularly if you're watching this tutorial a long time after when it was originally created, then if you are having any problems, do let me know and I'll try and change the code base to update it to make sure that everything is working as expected. One of the most powerful features of Visual Studio Code is just how customizable it is. It's incredible. So if we go over to the ribbon at the top, go to code I've selected on Mac here, settings, and you're looking for settings. So code, settings, settings. Inside of here, there are many different settings that we can configure. And the idea here is that we're trying to attach Black to Visual Studio Code. So though when we save our code, it will automatically run Black and format our code, thus kind of presenting it in a way that's nice and consistent throughout our application. So if I type in Python here, it then takes me to an area where I can set up different features, different options when writing in the Python programming language. A bit further down here, it says formatting. So in actual fact, it looks like it's already set up for Black. So I just need to kind of connect everything together. So this is one way of changing the settings of Visual Studio Code. Now we can kind of override these settings, which is great. And that's what we're going to do. So we're going to create a new file in the root of our project, a new folder. So this folder is going to be outside of DRF. So we don't want to put it there. So let's make a new folder. Okay, we're going to call this .vscode. VSCode. There we go. And then inside of here, we're going to create a new file called settings. So the whole idea here is that Visual Studio Code, when it runs, when it loads up, it's going to look for this folder. It's going to look for these settings files. Oh, no, it's not a PI file. It's a JSON file. Apologies. It's going to look for this file and then just change any of the settings that we have described here. So this is the JSON file. So we're going to need to utilize the JSON notation for this. So we open up the brackets. Let's go ahead and turn on some of the different settings, if you like. So there are a few different ways of doing this. So essentially what I'm doing here is I'm describing something that's in the settings here. So the editor, and let's go format on save. So this is an option that you'll find. If I copy this, go into settings again, and I can just paste this up here, and then that would take me to the settings right here. So we're just manually setting this up as we to our preferred choice here. So format and save, let's go for true. Okay, so we're going to turn it on. So what we're saying here is that whenever we save, and we're going to have autosave anyway. So anytime we type anything, Visual Studio Code will autosave potentially. And then at that point, it will then format the Python code. So that's essentially what we're doing there. So we're going to need a comma. So we turn that on. And then we tell Visual Studio Code for Python formatting provider. So for formatting, we're going to be utilizing black. That's what we have just installed via the Python package index. And we will find that there are loads of different settings. I say loads, there are a few different settings for black. So we can change some of those settings. Just need to go over to the black package page on the Python package index, have a look at the documentation, and you can have a look at some of the things you can change here. Now, one thing that you might want to change straight away is the line length, and that's going to be obviously your preference, how long you want each line to be. So it's going to format that for you. So we're going to set that at around about 88. You might want a bit longer, so it's just a random number. There is no particular reason why I'm selecting 88, in case you were wondering there. I think it's a good line length for my preference. Okay, so with that in place, all we need to do now, or some other settings that we can define. So let's go for Python, referring to the fact that we want to change some Python settings. And then we're going to go for the editor code action on save. So we can set the code action on save here. So what we want to do? Well, we want to also organize the imports. So source.organizeImports. There we go. Just waiting for that. And then we can turn that on too. So in addition to kind of formatting with black, we'll go ahead and also format the imports at the top consistently. So, okay, editor. Let's see what we've done here. So we have open editor.codeActionOnSave. So we need to be careful with the capitals. So code action on save, editor, looks like it's okay. The problem here is I didn't include the S. It's code actions on save, that's why. Okay, so we've got code actions on save, and we're going to also organize the imports. Right, there we go. So let's give that a go within our code. So now we've set that up, let's just close that, close the settings and everything here. So let's now go into our project. Let's just pick, for example, the base here. Let's go ahead and just build something like this. Okay. So you can see here that when I press save, it's looking to actually format the page. So let me just make a mistake. And you can see that when I press save, on save, black is then being utilized to actually format the page. So let me see if this works. So I tried to move everything back
indentation. And you can see that when I press save, it's indented it. So essentially, that is all that's happening here. Now, it's quite a powerful thing because it means that our code will be consistently formatted throughout the whole application. If you are interested in styling, formatting, and you are new to Python and you haven't yet had a look at PEP 8, PEP 8 is a style guideline for Python code. It's a very popular style guideline, and this is going to give you some information which is going to help you identify how to actually present your code on the page. Now, Black is essentially utilizing these guidelines to automatically format your code for you. So in actual fact, you don't need to read this. You don't need to know anything about this, but I do highly recommend that you have a read through. And if any time you're wondering, oh, how do I actually present a variable correctly? Or how do I actually write a variable? What's the naming convention? Well, you could potentially utilize this PEP 8 convention. And again, it is just a convention. You don't have to follow it. But these are some really good guidelines if you are new to Python and you've got those kind of niggly questions like, you know, how do I build a class? You know, how do I name a class correctly? What's the correct syntax? How many spaces do I use between X, Y, and Z? So this is where you're going to find that type of information. So although I was only able to give you a quick, simple preview of what Black is doing in terms of lining things up and actually presenting our code visually on the page, that's a really powerful tool which we will use throughout this development process. And by the end of the development, we will have a consistently formatted code base.